Hello, everyone. You listen to another Coffees with Toffees podcast. I will be your host, Flub, and this is the Flubdate. We have a great show for you tonight, as always, and tonight we're going to be talking a little bit about the team transfers that have been happening, and not only the team transfers that have been happening, but we are also going to talk about the tournaments that they are affecting, and we are going to be talking just a little bit about, generally, we're going to be talking about the Summit 7, and we're going to be talking about the Epicenter 2017 qualifiers. So some exciting stuff as we move forward, and let's begin with the team transfers, because everyone needs to know what's going on with the team so you know who to root for. So let's start off with WG Unity has now dropped Ajit and Afu, two awesome names, but they have now dropped those guys out of their team, and we now have LGD Forever Young has now dropped Jinxing and IPC, and have now gained Afu, which was, as I formerly mentioned, was on WG Unity, and Inflame, who is actually formerly on CDEC. We also have a little bit of a switch up here in the European scene. We got, and the American scene, we have Yapzor now is joining Team Secret, and he's taking over for PyLiDai, and PyLiDai is now leaving Team Secret to join his former teammates on Team NP. Something that everyone should be excited for. Any NP fan should be excited for seeing them reunite, as well as Fada coming back to the scene, and he's now joining NP as well. So this should be a really interesting team. Really, someone made a comment online about, you know, they're just all, this was just a plan to get rid of Bone 7, but you know, Bone 7 is still going to be their coach and he's still a valued member of the team, so I understand that it's a funny joke, but they also have a lot of potential with this team. It was good before and I think that it could be very good again. PyLiDai is very sacrificial as a support, and I kind of think that it lends itself to the lineup in general, and I think PyLiDai and Aoi 2000 have a general history of playing together that is just stronger than most other support duos, so they should come out strong and be winning pretty well in these next few tournaments. So let's talk about these next few tournaments. We got the Summit 7 qualifiers that are here playing right now, and the Summit 7 main tournament starts June 14th, and it's going to be in Los Angeles, and the prize pool is $100,000. So not as big as the major tournaments that we've been seeing, or something like TI that we're gearing up for, or, you know, the majors in general. But this is still a good tournament. It's still fun, and hopefully it gets in more people, that more teams, tier 2, tier 3 teams that we don't normally get to see. The direct invites for this tournament were VP, Team VDJ, and Team Secret. So no real surprises there. I know Team VGJ is a great team. I'm actually surprised that they didn't get another upper team, like OG or something like that. Probably they are going for other tournaments at this point. Or maybe they're just pushed out altogether because the prize pool is a little lower first for major winners in general. So it could make a lot of sense. We also have the CEA, or Southeast Asia qualifier, has been finished up a few weeks ago, and Clutch Gamers took that spot from many upper teams, and they really didn't deserve this position for sure. It's a great team. I am actually very excited to see what they do in the future. I think that they are actually going to be one of the teams that are in Epicenter, and I'm hoping that they do really well again. I hope that this team is something, a new up-and-comer team, because it's always good to get new blood in the mix. We got on the China qualifier, they will actually not be playing until the 9th, so we have some time to wait for that, not only for the main tournament, but for the qualifier for China as well. And the European and American teams, American qualifiers, has been started today as of the 7th of May, and they will end on the 14th, both of them will. And the teams to look out for in these two tournaments are going to be the EU side is going to have Mouse Sports, Alliance, Na'Vi, Team Empire, Cloud9, Ninjas in Pajamas, Pro Dota Gaming, and Vega Squadron. So pretty packed lineup. Some you could say tier 2, tier 1 teams all within the mix. Just some really great Dota that's going to be happening. I've recognized and have followed all of them, and I know you probably have as well. So if there's some games you are interested in, you should definitely watch some Summit 7 EU qualifiers. We also have on the American side, we have Team NP, Complexity Gaming, Digital Chaos, SG Esports, Infamous, Midas Elite Club, Thunderbirds, and IsGG. Horrible name, by the way, IsGG. New Blood is New Blood, and they actually got in from a pre-qualifier type thing, so more congratulations to them, and I hope they do well in this tournament. I hope they do well in general just so that they can have a sponsor, kind of sponsor them and get rid of that name, because IsGG is an awful way to, for any announcer to say the name and, oh gosh, like, this guy's on, IsGG. It's just, it doesn't flow correctly at all. So, I just, yeah, we'll move past that. I just had to rant for a second. And we'll go into the Epicenter qualifiers, the Epicenter 2007 qualifiers. 10 years ago. So we got, the tournament is going to be in Moscow. No surprise there. Epicenter generally is in Moscow. And the prize pool will be $250,000 this time. So once again, somewhat of a smaller tournament, but something that we can still enjoy. And the Epicenter group stage starts on June the 4th to June the 7th. The main tournament will be starting from June the 9th to June the 11th. And the teams will be separated into two different groups, and they will be groups of five. And the top three of each team will, of each group, will play in the playoffs. Also, the teams that win the group stage will generally already have a bye into the tournament. They will be in the semifinals, and the teams that are both second and third, or like fourth and lower, or was it? It's third and lower, are going to be playing off at the quarterfinal stage, and they'll move up from there. So it's going to generally be it's not double elimination. It's going to be just a normal tournament. You can knock anyone out if you play well enough. So it's going to be a fun tournament. I'm excited for this one in particular. It's not that the other one's bad, but this one should have some really good teams. The teams that are invited directly are OG, EG, Virtus Pro, Liquid, Team Liquid, Invictus Gaming, and one that is still to be determined. And I'm still trying to figure out what's going on there. There hasn't been any leaks yet of who's being invited, but they've already been getting qualifiers, so we'll have to see who's getting actually invited here. And as I was kind of saying before, all the qualifiers have began yesterday, except the American qualifiers. The American qualifiers did begin today, the 7th, and they're going to be going on the rest of this week. All the qualifiers, even though America started later, it is going to end up being done by May the 14th. So you have all this week to watch great Dota from all the different areas. So I'm going to kind of run through all the areas, let you know where your favorite teams are going to be playing and who's up on these qualifiers. So we got in the Americas, we got Team NP, Team Fire, Midas Elite Club Elite. I always want to say Elite Club because it just makes more sense, but Midas Club Elite, Complexity Gaming, SG Esports, Thunderbirds, Elite Wolves, and IsGG. Once again, that name kills me. We got CIS Europe for their qualifiers. We got Team Spirit, Team Empire, Team Secret, Navi, Alliance, Effect, Vega Squadron, and Team Singularity. All these teams are very recognizable. I feel like when CIS and Europe kind of come together, there's not a lot of new blood from that situation, just because there's so much, it's so saturated in that region. Kind of like Chinese, a lot of times I have already heard of the Chinese teams, and not only that, they have like their lower teams working in on it, so it kind of feels like that kind of gets to a point of saturation, and that kind of stinks, but you know, maybe the tournament will be a little bit better in their region because they have stronger, more distinguished teams. In CEA, we have the Team Faceless, Fnatic, Happy Feet, Mineski, Clutch Gamers, TNC Pro Team, we have MVP Revolution, and Geek Fam. So a good matchup there as well, something to be very excited about. Personally, I have seen Clutch Gamers quite a few times, like I was kind of talking about earlier in this cast, and I've generally seen a lot of really good plays, and there's been a little bit of sloppiness here and there, but they did beat out teams like Team Faceless and Fnatic and TNC Pro in the qualifiers before for Summit 7. So maybe they can clutch another victory once again and kind of take it home for CEA. I would really like to see them in more tournaments. China, they have eHome, Keen.Keen. They have IG Vitality representing. They have LGD Gaming, LGD Forever Young, Newbie, Team VGJ, VC Gaming, and VC Gaming Potential. So, like I was saying before, they have a lot of potential within these teams, but it kind of seems a little saturated. I, for one, am a little excited to see the Americas, because there's a lot of new blood in there. I'd also like to see SG Esports doing well again. They did phenomenal in the majors, and I'd like to see them move into a stronger position and kind of go from here, kind of more developing the scene for their region as well. So, this is, I know this is kind of a short cast tonight, and I did plan it to go a little bit longer. I think I talked a little bit faster. But I will give you kind of a bonus here tonight as we're talking. So there was a thing that I didn't catch the other week on my cast. And I want to kind of leave this for all the people out there that are going to be captains and are looking to just generally, if you feel like you've gotten kind of stale with your style and you feel like you want to switch it up a little bit, understand the game a little bit better, try to do ability draft. I know it sounds like I'm trolling here, but it's very, very strong to do. A lot of times you can get different abilities on the same hero and be like, oh man, I could totally pick that combination and kind of feel the farm out and feel how the game goes from there. Kind of try different things with your team. So if you find yourself in a stale type of situation, maybe try out ability draft. Give it a run. See how it feels for your team and just play it like once or twice. Just get a few ideas to spawn in your head about different combinations you can do. It's something that Aoi said in the majors on when he was on the panel, and I completely agree with him, because he was talking about Puppy and how Puppy would run certain different things, and it's interesting to get that look on ideas. Actually, I think it was 1437 that said it. Yeah, I think it was 1437. But one of those two, anyway. And as that was, even though that was a bonus, let's close out the show. I know you guys got more important Dota to get back to. We got all these games to watch. They're going currently on right now. So go back to watching them. We're going to close out here. Thanks to Bass Rebels for being themselves and providing free music to guys like me. We also got, if you want to help us out, you can subscribe or like any of our videos. You can go to our Twitch channel, twitch.tv/toffees_dota2. Couldn't get that out for some reason. We got our YouTube channel at 5 Midas Gaming. If you also want to give to our Patreon, if you're extra generous, you can go to our Patreon at www.patreon.com/toffees. If you are wanting to just listen to the audio versions so you don't have to see my ugly mug, you can always go follow us at Stitcher, iTunes, or SoundCloud. If you have any questions for me or Toffees, you can follow Toffees at ToffeesTV at his Twitter, or you can follow me at my Twitter at FlubDota. If you have any types of casting needs or anything in general that you feel like that needs to be an issue that you have with something that's been going on, or just something that you want to talk to me about Dota with, you can always send me an email, crazyflub@gmail.com. Well, you guys have now been updated. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I will catch you guys next week, or next Friday for the Brewmasters Draft, or next Sunday for the Flub Date again. Alright guys, catch you next week. See ya!